നമസ്കാരം. യുവർ ഡോക്ടറിന്റെ ഇന്നത്തെ എപ്പിസോഡിലേക്ക് എല്ലാവർക്കും സ്വാഗതം. നമ്മളിതാ എത്തിയിട്ടുണ്ട്. നമ്മുടെ പ്രേക്ഷകർക്ക് സംശയങ്ങൾക്കും ക്ലാരിഫിക്കേഷൻസിനും വേണ്ടി താഴെ കാണുന്ന നമ്പറിൽ വിളിക്കാവുന്നതാണ്. 0529611333 എന്നുള്ള നമ്പറിലേക്കാണ് വിളിക്കേണ്ടത്. നമ്മളോടൊപ്പം ഇന്ന് ജോയിൻ ചെയ്തിട്ടുള്ള ഡോക്ടർ ഡോക്ടർ ശാരദ ബ്രാറ്റ ഘോഷ്. ഷീ ഈസ് ദി ഹെഡ് ഓഫ് ഡിപ്പാർട്ട്മെന്റ് ആൻഡ് സ്പെഷ്യലിസ്റ്റ് ഓബ്സ് ആൻഡ് ഗൈനെ cosmetic gynae surgeon and keyhole surgeon, right? I don't know exactly. the technical name. So she's basically from Saudi German hospital Dubai. Welcome to the show, doctor.
Thank you, it's my pleasure to come over here.
I'm really sorry that I don't know the technical terms to explain. That's why I just read it from here. It's head of department, specialist obs and gynae.
Yes, I'm the head of the department in obs and gynae. I'm a laparoscopic and a cosmetic surgeon as
laparoscopic.
Well.
That yes. is the keyhole surgery.
Yes, yes. That's a keyhole surgery. We put only few holes in the tummy of the woman. Uh-huh. And with these holes, we can take out whatever pathology the patient has.
Okay.
The beauty of the surgery is that only it doesn't give any scars to the patient. Uh-huh, and the recovery uh-huh. is very fast.
Nowadays, even this is used for delivery, I guess, cesarean.
No.
It's different?
Yes, that's different. In keyhole surgery, the size of the holes are ranging from 5 millimeters to 10 millimeters.
Oh,
so,
okay.
it's that small
millimeter.
Size. That's millimeter we are telling.
Oh, okay.
So, almost scarless surgery.
All right.
Although cesarean section, we do a very perfect job. And it's now almost scarless cesarean sections also we are doing.
All right. Appo prekshakara shraddhike, today we'll be talking about the menstrual issues in ladies, right?
Yes.
Menstrual problems in the gynecology related aayittulla endu samshayangalkkum nammude prekshakarkku vilikkavundana. She'll be answering to all your queries. So, doctor, basically what is the major like menstrual related issues in ladies?
Yeah, if we see from the adolescent when the child gets her menarche, these can be irregular, you know, and sometimes it can be heavy flows also.
Okay.
So sometimes the child is so shy that she doesn't want to tell her mother. So nowadays in schools, the teachers are teaching them about all these changes which she is going to develop. But sometimes the child is unable to tell the parents. But it is also our duty to know from the child that what is happening to her. Sometimes the period can be very heavy. Sometimes there can be an underlying pathology, sometimes ovarian tumors, which could lead to menstrual irregularities. So, as the woman, child is getting menarche, we should be asking her and we should make it more obvious or frank to the child so that it is nothing different which is happening. This is a normal physiological change which is going to happen. So, any problem like menstrual heavy bleeding, all can be taken care by the doctor. Sometimes we need to do some investigation like checking for the ultrasound, seeing the uterus and the ovaries if there is any problem. It all can be taken care. Only thing is that we should be making it more obvious to the child so that the child is open and can discuss with the doctor or the parent or the teacher.
All right. Whenever we think about this menstrual issues and gynecology related issues, the first thing comes into our mind is cyst.
Right.
What is a cyst actually?
Actually, in the ovary, there are, to start with, it's a follicle. It's a follicle. Every cycle, every month, a woman forms a ovarian follicle.
Mm.
Once it reaches to its maximum size, then it ovulates and the it forms a corpus luteal and it regresses then.
Okay.
Which is normal. But sometimes this follicle keep on growing. Up to a size of 5 centimeter, we can sometimes ignore it. It is if it is containing only fluid like a water-filled cyst. But sometimes these cysts can be dangerous also.
Okay.
Like solid, showing high vascularity, like blood vessels, which can be tumorous, you know, tumor
oh.
also.
Okay.
Which there is a different age group in small children also, like in teenagers, when they start menstruating, or even younger women, children, can also get these cysts, but these will show some changes. Sometimes a cyst can grow huge in size and can give abdominal pain, menstrual irregularities. But if you are feeling any pain or irregularities, it's always good to do a checkup with the doctor. It's also recommended that all the women should do an annual checkup with their gynecologist so that they are screening for the cervical cancer, even for the breast cancer, they can do the ultrasound. And for the uterus and ovaries, they are checking with their doctor. So that annually, if you are taking care of ourselves, all the things are noted. So it can be taken care.
All right. So the cyst is same as the cancer or tumor?
No. Most of the cysts are benign. That means 95% to 98% those are not cancerous.
Okay.
So we should be relieved that actually we are not going to have or we are having something. Mm-hmm. It's only important to check that is there any problem. Mm-hmm. So you can check with the doctor. They will also do some investigation, ultrasound, mm-hmm. blood test to check that whether it is normal or mm-hmm. abnormal. Most of the cyst regresses with due course of time. Within 2-3 months, they usually regress if they are normal.
Okay.
So just checking for a couple of months, it should be fine.
Will it affect like a person's delivery or the...
Usually as these cysts are benign and normal functional cysts, they will not cause any problem.
Okay. So even if it's there, we can like...
If it is a normal small size cyst, usually it regresses. It doesn't cause any problem.
Okay. And how about PCOD?
PCOS is a very upcoming, like many, we see that it's a many children are having this one. We can say this is a pandemic which is arising, but we do not know why is it so. Is it our food habits, our day-to-day lifestyle which is actually causing this? Mm. Polycystic ovary syndrome is the presence of multiple cysts in the ovary.
Uh-huh. So it's related to the cyst?
The cyst size is between 2 to 10 millimeters. These are multiple, more than 10 in numbers. Mm. Cyst is only when a big cyst is there in the ovary. Polycystic, there are many cysts which are there in the ovary, but these are very small in sizes.
What happens
because of this polycystic ovary, the woman has irregular periods, menstrual abnormalities, some hormonal changes which can lead to acne, hirsutism, all these things. Sometimes it can also lead to like subfertility, but all these things can be managed. It is like people get many of my patients come and tell that I have been told that I am having PCOS, will I ever have a baby or no? So it's not like that, you know. Sometimes it can be a very mild issue, and with just lifestyle changes and food habits, everything can be fine, absolutely.
Okay. So, when I was getting fat, you know, someone told me that you should check your PCOD, maybe thyroid, all this stuff. That's why I just asked you, is PCOD, like PCOD can change our, like, you know, physique and all?
Yes. As in polycystic ovaries, the hormonal imbalance is there, but this that many times it is due to genetic inheritance, but many times it is not otherwise also. So, as we are taking care of our physical health, exercising and producing right type of hormones, if you are eating lot of fat and that is converted to hormones, that will definitely lead to some changes which may lead to the PCOS. Mm-hmm, so, if you are by exercising, we are changing this type of fat to different type of fat and we are metabolizing this fat, this will not happen.
What are the remedies for this PCOD? Treatment?
It depends on at what stage it is detected. If it is an adolescent girl who is having this PCOS, and it may be due to her lifestyle, so what sort of food she is eating, a balanced diet which should be encouraged, like she should be eating 2 portions of the veggies, 1 portion of protein and 1 portion of carbs only, which is the, I think our Indian diet is, most of it is carbs, so we can change that thing. Another thing is that we should be exercising, you know, in a week time, our exercise should be 2.5 moderate exercise. Mm-hmm. Now, what is moderate exercise is that once we doing moderate exercise, we are still able to talk in that one. Vigorous exercise is that when we do exercise, we are unable to talk with the strength of intensity of that exercise.
Okay.
So, only with these things, minimal of things like weight reduction and exercising and your diet change, we can cure most of the PCOS patient. If it is not cured with these ones, now we have to see what the patient is suffering. Is it a menstrual irregularity which she is facing? Then the hormone supplement can be given which will regularize her period. If she is facing infertility, then there are medicines which will make her ovulate and then she can conceive.
Okay. Yeah. Some people face late of menstrual, like, you know, some people don't get menstruous even after 10 years or 16 years like that. What can be reasons for that?
So, the age of menarche varies from 9 to 16 years of age. if the woman is not getting periods until 16 years of age and her all the secondary sexual characters are already developed, then she should undergo all the investigation whether the internal structures like uterus, ovaries are functioning well, where the hormones profile is absolutely normal or not. Or if the woman is at 14 years of age and there is no secondary sexual character development. So now there are various reasons for this one. Mm. This is all linked to our hypothalamus pituitary axis from the brain to the uterus. Okay. There is a cycle, circle which is formed. So we have to, by means of all these tests, we'll find out what is the cause. Many a times, just with the medications, the menstruation can be taken care, but it's very important if a child doesn't get her periods by 16 years of age, we should check. Now, precocious puberty is also happening quite often, like women before the child, before the age of 9, they are getting menstruation.
Oh.
So, if this is happening, then her stature remains short.
Mm.
But now our endocrinologists, they are doing a great job. So these all things also can be taken care of, and okay. She can be this her menarche can be pushed off to a certain age when until that age she can gain a good height.
Oh, so that won't have any side effects?
Usually not. We have these are all new things. Research is definitely going on all these things, but until now not major issues have been seen.
Okay, so what are the basic menstrual related issues in teenage girls?
Many girls do not get their periods regular. It is usually the interval is quite large, you know, they are getting separated for, but sometimes they are also facing heavy bleeding.
Okay.
Abnormal, and this disturbs their studies.
Mm-hmm.
So if they are not getting regular periods, usually in first two to three years after her menarche, it takes time to settle for the from the hypothalamus pituitary axis. It should make a coordination, and usually it establishes the menarche by 2 years after the menarche, the cycle established. But if these things are happening, that she is not getting regular period, just see the your obstetrician, you know, gynecologist, then they will find out the reason for it. And if only with the hormonal supplement, she will be fine.
Okay. So, in a healthy person, what should be the interval normally?
The menstrual cycle usually ranges from 21 to 35 days of interval.
Okay.
And the period usually lasts from 3 to 7 days of cycle.
Okay.
So, we say that if it is less than 21 days or more than 35 days, it is abnormal.
Okay.
Once the bleeding is more than 7 days, or the bleeding is quite heavy, like she is soaking more than 25 pads in a menstrual cycle, that is also abnormal, or she is passing a lot of clots, you know, these are the times that she should seek opinion of a doctor.
All right. Even in teenage girls, like we see other fluids also, right, other than the spirits, blood flow, like some white discharge and all we usually
see. Those are normal things. Our organs like the cervix usually produces hormones and secretions which are related to the estrogen and the progesterone which are produced in the by the body. So these are absolutely normal things. These discharges are considered abnormal only when they are in copious amount, like too much is secreted and the child or the adult woman needs to wear a daily pad for that one, or there is a discoloration, or
like
it's a
yellow color is
yellow
normal?
Green. Only white color is normal. When
okay.
it is yellow, green, or it's foul smelling, some smell is coming. Maybe sometimes these are just a mild form of infection. Just check with the doctor. It should be fine then.
All right. And coming to the menopause.
Yeah.
Like the age, like after age of 50, I guess, right?
Yes, the menopause in Indian women is 49 years, but it ranges from like 48 to 52 years of age.
Okay, before coming to that, we have a caller with us. Let's see who is it. Hello.
Hello.
Good evening, Aaron.
Ente peru Kavita.
Okay, hi Kavita. Doctor odu samsarichollo.
Hello, doctor.
Hi, yes.
How are you?
I'm very good. What about you?
Yeah, fine, thank you.
Yeah.
Middle age le menstrual time le abdominal cramps koodunnade kaaranam endana ladies?
What is the reason
of the menstrual cramps?
Yeah.
Yes, menstrual cramps is happening
in middle age.
in middle age. Yeah. So we have to see that whether this woman was having menstrual cramps of same intensity before or this has increased, you know. If the menstrual cramps has increased, there is a possibility there is some pathology which is developing in the body, like sort of polyps or fibroids. We have to see that okay. whether the patient was okay. having some problem before or it is a new development in her body. Or sometimes the infection okay. can also lead to these cramps. So just check, it should be fine. As I was telling that doing an annual checkup is always recommended. You know, we shouldn't be ignorant about our body health.
Okay, okay.
Yes.
Thank you, doctor.
Thank you. My pleasure.
Thank Bye-bye. You so much, Kavita. Yeah. Bye-bye. Take care. All right, and coming to an interesting topic actually, mm-hmm. Like she has innovated a technique called ASSST by which she has saved like a lot of lives of mothers after delivery. What is ASSST?
Yes, this is alternate sequential suture tightening technique.
Okay.
As we know that many women after childbirth, they die.
Okay.
And the most common reason of this death is atony of the uterus. The uterus doesn't contract.
Okay.
You know? So by this simple method which I have innovated and published and also presented in many international conferences also, this is a compression suture.
Okay.
So we just, what I do in this technique is I put a compression suture around the uterus. So we uterus which is big in size, I just put a suture by which the uterus becomes very small.
Okay.
As the uterus becomes very small, the blood vascular channels which are actually popping out and the blood is coming through will be also collapsed.
Okay.
So as I make this one, the uterus doesn't bleed anymore. By these means, many times, like as I'm the head of the department, many of my colleagues had this problem after postpartum hemorrhage. Their patient was bleeding, and they called me, you know, and I came there and I put the suture. And although this is not only like with my help, the patient was saved. We need a full running blood bank facility, a good ICU, anesthetic team. And as our hospital is a tertiary care center, we have all these backup with us and all run 24/7, they are all working. So with all these things, the patient was not only rescued for her life, but also for she was having the uterus, you know, so that she can have more children if she wants to have in later on.
Okay. So this ASSST is a surgical procedure.
It's a surgical procedure.
Okay. This is usually done soon after the delivery or?
See, there are many methods by which we can just manage this problem of atony. 80% of the women who are bleeding after delivery is due to atony of the uterus. So first it is managed with the medications. We try to give the medications.
Okay.
If it works with the medication, we don't need to do anything.
Okay.
There is another method that we put a tamponade, like we put something inside the uterus so that it compresses the uterus and it doesn't bleed.
Okay.
If still doesn't work, then we take it as the third resort.
Okay.
Usually before it was told that many women had to undergo the hysterectomy. We had to remove the uterus to save her life.
Oh.
But now with this this small procedure, which doesn't take more than like, if I start the procedure, it doesn't take me more than half an hour to do this procedure. And with this just a simple technique, the woman's life and the uterus is saved.
All right. And coming back to menopause, that is a like a natural phenomenon. So we can't stop that. But still, during that time, a lot of people undergo a lot of like pressure, the mental stress, and due to the hormonal changes, they feel like the hotness, something like that,
yes,
right?
Yes, yes.
So what can be the like precautions? What are the remedies we can, you know, control at least a little
See,
bit?
See, nowadays the women don't want to age. every woman thinks like that, I don't want to age, you know. And but the remedies for the menopausal woman is controversial, like taking hormone replacement therapy is controversial. Lot of research has come that it can lead to breast cancer or the endometrial cancer. But that is mostly due to the, once we take the pills which also contains the estrogen, you know. And but if we take estrogen primed with the progesterone also, usually these things do not happen. But as this is an absolute controversial topic, some women do not want to take any hormone therapy. But there are natural remedies also. Phytoestrogens can be given to the woman, calcium supplementation can be given.
Okay.
So all these things can be taken care of. If the patient is actually suffering from the hot flashes, which is something sometimes it's very annoying. So these women can be given these hormone replacement therapy, and after some time it can be withdrawn slowly as well.
All right. So, menopause feel in aarkengilo okke upagarapettu nu vicharikkana. And coming to another problem due to fibroid ovarian cyst or cancer by keyhole surgery by like laparoscopy.
Yes.
So, what is that fibroid ovarian cyst?
Yes. So, by laparoscopic surgery, all these can be treated. As the woman was asking that she is feeling cramping, you know, it can be a possibility that she is having a fibroid, or the other woman also having fibroid. Fibroid will lead, can cause many problems like menorrhagia, like heavy bleeding, pain in the abdomen. Sometimes big fibroids can be also the reason for infertility. So these fibroids can range, go up to size of 20, 30 centimeters even. But with these keyhole surgery, which I am telling that 5 to 10 millimeters only, not even centimeters, you know, these small surgeries, we put laparoscope, small thin instruments go, which are like telescope sort of thing, and we separate this fibroid from the uterus, and we, with these holes, we take by small pieces from the body. So this whole fibroid can be removed with these all small holes, even for the ovarian cyst also.
Okay.
Now, nowadays, all the surgeries which were done before with laparotomy, like full incision which were given before, we don't need to do it. All surgeries can be done by laparoscopic surgery.
All right. Going back to another caller, doctor. Hello.
Hello. Hi.
Hi. Good evening.
Good evening.
Yes. Arana.
Deepa.
Yes. You can talk to the doctor.
Hi doctor, just wanted to check, like, what are the reasons for early menopause?
See, now the early menopause, I have seen that our Indian subcontinent are getting quite early the menopause nowadays. The reason behind it, whether they have been exposed to some sort of medications in their whole life that they are getting this menopause, or they have faced the infertility problem, so that they have taken a lot of ovulation induction drugs, which has led to these menopause, early menopause. But usually the menopause age is around 49 in Indian women. So usually the menopause should be around that age. Yes.
So what happens if something related to this in the age of early 30s?
Yeah, now we have to see that if she is actually under, has menopause now, and whether she is married, she is wishing for a pregnancy by the means of IVF, in vitro fertilization. If the woman actually has attained their menopause, and we see antral follicle count of her anti-mullerian hormone levels also, which we can find out how, up to what level her ovaries are either functioning, not functioning, how low level it is, you know. So,
okay.
Yeah, with these tests, we can come to know that how much her ovarian reserve is there. If she is wishing for any further fertilities, she can undergo IVF treatment, and most of the time they attain babies. So, they shouldn't be just hiding their problem. They should seek help for their problem.
Okay, totally understand. Yeah. Thanks a lot, doctor.
Thank you so much, dear. Bye-bye. Yes, അപ്പോ എന്തായാലും എൻഡിലേക്ക് കടക്കാണ് നമ്മൾ വൈൻഡ് അപ്പിലേക്ക്. ബട്ട് ബിഫോർ ദാറ്റ് ഫൈനൽ ക്വസ്റ്റ്യൻ ഡോക്ടർ, ലൈക്ക് സം പീപ്പിൾ ടേക്ക് പിൽസ് ടു കൺട്രോൾ ദ ക്രാംപ്സ് ഡ്യൂരിങ് പീരിയഡ്സ്, ഈസ് ഇറ്റ് ആക്ച്വലി ഗുഡ്?
യെസ്, ഇറ്റ് ഡിപെൻഡ്സ് ഓൺ, ലൈക്ക് സീ ദി ക്രാംപിംഗ് ഈസ് ഹാപ്പൻ സം ടൈം മോസ്റ്റ്ലി because the endometrium is trying to come out of the uterus, and the uterus is trying to shut it off, you know. But we have to see how severe is the cramping.
Okay.
Sometimes a child may be vomiting, throwing up, and she is unable to go to school. If this is her level of like pain, we should score the pain. If anything more than 5, then I think she needs some analgesics to relieve this pain. But some more, we need to also check why this pain is happening. There are sometimes some cases like endometriosis, some pathology inside, which may be the reason for her this severe sort of dysmenorrhea, you know, severe pain which she is having. So all these things can be taken care of. Just checking with the doctor will sort out your problem.
All right. Unfortunately, the episode is winding up here. I know a lot of questions you may have. And then our prekshakarkku korchengil nammal angotte convey cheyan patti nu vishwasikkana. Doctor, a lot more questions to ask even. But still, unfortunately, we are winding up this episode here. And then our prekshakarkku clear aayenu vishwasikkana. That was Dr. Sharda Brata Ghosh from Saudi German Hospital with us. നമ്മുടെ ഈ ഒരു എപ്പിസോഡിൽ താങ്ക് യു സോ മച്ച് ഡോക്ടർ ഫോർ ബീയിങ് ഹിയർ ആൻഡ് സ്പെൻഡിംഗ് ഹാഫ് ആൻ അവർ വിത്ത്
us. It's my pleasure as well. Thank you.
Thank you so much. നമ്മളിപ്പോ ഈ ഒരു എപ്പിസോഡ് വൈൻഡ് അപ്പ് ചെയ്യാണ്. മറ്റൊരു എപ്പിസോഡുമായി വീണ്ടും കാണാം. Till then, this is Nisha signing off from your doctor from NTV US, number one Indian television channel. Bye bye.
ജനങ്ങൾക്കൊപ്പം വാർത്തയ്ക്കൊപ്പം നന്മയോടൊപ്പം NTV UAE to the world.